Good morning, everyone. Good morning. How's everyone doing? You enjoying the venture? You're joining this event so far, Venture 135. Oh my God. It is morning time, right? So I hope you guys are all enjoying yourself so far, getting a lot of good content, some good information, lots of networking. My name is Ty Chandler. I'm the Senior Diversity Inclusion and Belonging Lead at AvidXchange, and we are proud partners of RevTech and happy to bring you this pitch party today. So I know that some folks are just kind of coming in, so I'll give you a second to, you know, to grab your seats, but just to tell you a little bit about me as well as AvidXchange and why we're here. So I've been at AvidXchange for almost 4 years, joining initially in communications, but you know, venturing over to the diversity, inclusion, and belonging side because it's a big passion of mine, and I think it's, you know, could potentially be a big passion of many of those who are here. At AvidXchange, you know, we really take diversity, inclusion, and belonging seriously. We've made commitments to create a culture where everyone, every teammate, every customer, every stakeholder feels the power of connection and also understands the value and sense of belonging. That's a big priority for us, and we're making a commitment to that on many levels. We work and strive towards that on a regular basis. We also are committed to engaging all of our employees, all of our AvidXers in our diversity, inclusion, and belonging journey, because we don't think it's just up to me as a DINB lead. It's up to all of us. And we also are committed to being a talent market leader in diversity, inclusion, and belonging by making sure that we are increasing representation for many groups that have traditionally been marginalized, especially in tech fields. So that's a big commitment for us at AvidXchange, which is, again, another reason why I'm excited to be here, because I understand that there are a lot of folks here that are looking to get some venture capital to grow their businesses. And at AvidXchange, we look at all of us as entrepreneurs. It's really the entrepreneur spirit that guides AvidXchange for the last 22 years. If you've never heard of us, we are a fintech company, though we like to think of ourselves as a people company. But our focus is really on, you know, providing middle market businesses an opportunity to really pay their bills in a much more effective way using our technology and our software. We were able to process over $180 billion, over 60 billion transactions just in a single year. So we move a lot of money at AvidXchange. So really exciting to be at this organization. And again, to partner with RevTech Labs as well as Venture 183 to bring you this event. So, speaking of diversity, inclusion, and belonging, some of you may be aware that only 2.6% of venture capital funds went to Black and Latinx founders in 2020, right? So there's definitely an opportunity for there to be more capital for more businesses to be able to grow and sustain themselves. Some of you may also know the value of diversity, inclusion, and belonging. When it comes to diversity, companies that have a diverse higher management, 40% of them are more likely to have higher profitability as well as productivity. Companies with more gender equality, 73% more likely to have higher productivity and higher profitability. So it does matter. It does matter. Representation matters, and making sure that there are opportunities for those to grow their businesses, making sure that there are opportunities for people of all races, of all diverse backgrounds, of all ethnicities, have an opportunity to really be successful. Those are very big priorities. So, with that being said, many of our founders that will be joining this pitch party are from underrepresented groups, okay? So there's an opportunity to learn a little bit more about what they're doing, what they're up to, and we're gonna give them an opportunity to make their pitch because I know they're really excited about sharing what they've been doing and also, too, sharing that all with you guys and impressing all of you guys with all of the great work that they have been up to. So up first, I got to speak to him briefly. He was like, what are you doing up here? I'm like, I'm gonna be speaking, so I'm gonna introduce you. So I'm gonna bring them up. So first we have Arbo, and Arbo is an all-in-one accounting, tax, and FPA SaaS platform for tech companies, providing real-time access to financial insights such as cash flow, burn rate, profitability, yearly taxes, and financial projections. And so we're gonna kick things off with Arbo. Come on up.
Oh. Hi. Thank you.
Good morning. Startup founders have the same goal, fundraise and grow. Although it can be rewarding, sometimes can be daunting. Hello, everyone. I'm Saurav. a CPA and founder at Arbo. And if you really think about it, sound accounting and finance functions reduce the failure rate of startups by 80%. But we always have one question: how do we do this at scale? But first, let's look at some macro trends. So based on AICPA's report, there was a 6.1% CAGR drop in accounting graduates in the past 7 years. I get it, accounting isn't sexy. Nobody wants to sit behind a desk and then post some journal entries, except some accountants. But couple that with the aging CPA population of around 55 years, we have a pending time bomb, or it's a recipe for disaster, right? So there's a big demand and supply gap that we need to close with technology. But the ones to suffer are the founders. You see, founders are already overwhelmed. 60% of them say that accounting and taxes are the worst part of their growth, because they need to rely on fragmented yet interdependent services. Take Lexi, for instance. She has a bookkeeper who looks at the transactions, a CPA that does her taxes, and doesn't even realize that she qualifies for R&D credits, and all hell broke loose when she was fundraising and she needed GAAP financials, projections, and issue convertibles. She needed multiple parties to come to her rescue. The overall market is huge. Like, as the startups grow and go through different stages, the need for finance support increases exponentially. And if you think about Lexi or any other startup founder, their goal is to get acquired or go IPO in the next 7 to 10 years. But what happens is they start with small accounting software, and then as they grow, get shoved into clunky ERPs, which are costly. So with the accounting industry, there is no unified, centralized, or a scalable solution for tech and SaaS companies, until Arbo, where we created an all-in-one finance tech stack for startups just like Lexi. Arbo automatically drives insights to key metrics that Lexi's investors want to see, like the burn rate, cash flow, capital allocation, without additional work. And my background is in corporate FP&A with Home Depot. So I wanted to instill the same corporate financial rigor in startups as well that reduces the failure rate by 80%. So Lexi is now ready. She can efficiently drive business with all the financial metrics on her side and is investor ready. Lexi is happy, and so are the 100 plus startups that were with Arbo. We grew 150% last year and are already profitable with a 96% retention rate. We have a great execution team and amazing advisors by our side who even drive our sales pipeline. And we're laser focused on US tech market right now, but eventually we'll be expanding to other verticals by 2025. And it's just the beginning. We've identified repeatable strategies to acquire new customers via partnerships. That's why we don't sell to CPAs. And we're the smartest accounting software ever built. Some of the names here, like QuickBooks, Xero, and Wave, were built for 30 million small businesses. And SAP and Oracle, the dinosaurs, were built for big enterprises. But Arbo's vision aligns with embedded finance, where startups can scale to be enterprise without migrating to clunky ERP softwares. And we're the only fintech solution out there simplifying founders' experience, with automated revenue recognition, GAAP financials, investor financials. There are multiple ways to skin the cat. And with a lightweight approach to ERP, we bring in our accounting and business intelligence expertise in our platform and integrate with startup-friendly apps like HubSpot, Gusto, and more. We're raising $2 million to scale our operations in our seed round. and we are going to be building the next generation of ERP, which hasn't been built since early 70s or 80s. So together, we can conquer a lot more market share. And if you're interested, hit me up in CrowdWorks or follow us on LinkedIn for more information. Thank you.
Thank you, Sarev, and thank you, Arbo. If you want to learn more about the company, again, go to CrowdWorks or use some of those networking opportunities to get to know Sarev himself and to learn and ask more questions about Arbo. All right, our next founder says for the price of a cell phone bill, they will provide guidance, action plans, and all kind of support for their customers to help close the wealth gap. Let's bring up Freeman Capital.
Quick test. All right, cool. Good afternoon. Well, actually, it's still good morning now. But my name is Calvin Williams, the founder of Freeman Capital, where we are making financial planning available to all. And what that means is that we are providing financial planning as a service to regional and community financial institutions. Take someone like Tiffany, a director of financial planning at a credit union with over 300,000 members, but only 6 advisors. She can't serve this whole community, and her management has said some public statements about wanting to be more inclusive and serve underserved communities. And she's on the hook for doing that, as well as increasing revenue. And so she's in a situation where she really only can sell more products to her wealthy clients. But with Freeman Capital, she gets a SEC-regulated platform with diverse certified financial planners and semi-automated advice that enables us to scale. And so together with Freeman Capital, she can now serve all of her retail clients. We help her to sell more than 3 times more financial products per person per year, and meeting her diversity requirements and mandates from the community and her management. She engages with us through a financial planning as a service yearly license that covers the members that we will serve. And when we onboard a member, they get an invitation and a notification that for the first time in their life, as an unaccredited investor or retail user, they get a chance to have a one-on-one call with a certified financial planner who will work with them. Onboarding is quick and easy. It takes less than 2 minutes. Yes, we focus on the financial part, but we also focus on the psychological part of things about financial anxiety that people carry when they're trying to build wealth. Within 24 hours of getting onto the platform, they get a chance to have a one-on-one call with a diverse planner that can resonate and help them to feel safe as they continue this wealth-building journey. There are 3 main values that make us very unique in this market, and I'm going to break down each one. The first, we did a 4,000-person survey to really understand the psychographic and the financial challenges that communities have when they're trying to build wealth for the first time. And we include that in our scalable advice from our platform and from our financial planners. The powerful part is that our advice is rooted in actions that would help to increase a person's net worth each and every 30 days. We cover everything from budgeting to debt to retirement, estate plans, and wills. Now, our customers love it, the financial institutions, because as we identify gaps in their end users' goals, we then plug in their own products. So we help to move more assets onto their balance sheet and help to sell more lending products and more that helps to make a win-win. The end users love it. We'll just go to Slack right now. With Tiffany and Freeman Capital, now she has her smaller team that can work with her wealthy clients, and we focus on everyone else while helping to increase her revenue. There we go. The reason why the end users love it is because we help to increase their net worth on average by 15% in the first year, and that's over 2 years' worth of data. We already have active deals with financial institutions, nonprofits, and influencers who want to bring financial planning as a service one-on-one to their community. This will enable us to have over $1 million in annual recurring revenue by the end of next year. And a really powerful part is that with our scalable platform, we will have more than 60 million recommendations and transactions running through our platform by the end of next year. We've already won multiple awards for disrupting financial planning, both local and nationally. And we have proven that to close the wealth gap, it's not just about access. It's also about advice. And even Vanguard did a study showing that working with a financial planner can increase your net worth, and we are proving that with retail customers every single day. Myself, I was recruited at 17 by the Department of Defense to build top-tier computer programs. Tanya, our chief financial planner, managed over $2.5 billion at JP Morgan and Wells. And Justin, our head of product, has been building tech products for over 20 years. We are Freeman Capital and Wealth Starts here. And if you're interested, we are in the process of closing up our seed round. Happy to discuss that on CrowdWorks or find me here. Thank you again and have a great day.
Thank you, Calvin, and thank you, Freeman Capital. Again, CrowdWorks is a way that you can learn more or, again, take advantage of those networking opportunities to get to speak with Calvin and his team in person. All right, our next founder delivers products committed to delivering simple, secure, and affordable solutions that enable better client engagement, efficiency of workflow, as well as sales opportunities. Up next, we have Proper.
Good morning, everybody. Thank you for having me. Just a quick show of hands. Any of you guys live in houses? Ever bought a house or a condo or vacation property or an office or something like that? Well, that's what Proper's kind of all about, right? As the headline says, it's kind of the Carfax for property, but with a built-in on-demand marketplace for services to maintain those properties. And I want to chat just a little bit about kind of why we're doing this. So, Merged Software is the company that I work for, and we make other software solutions primarily for the real estate industry, document management, workflow solutions, things like that. And we kind of accidentally came across this opportunity to build this product that we're calling Proper at a trade show in Vegas a few months ago. We were up there talking about our core products, and I had a slide in there about something that we kind of envisioned doing a couple years down the road. Well, next thing you know, we're getting hit up by about 8 or 10 national home builders, some big insurance companies, and we decided, well, we should probably make this a priority, so here we are. The primary reason for being here is we're looking for ideas and partnerships and things like that because we're so focused on kind of our core business, but this is an opportunity that we just can't kind of let go by. So the primary focus is just to simplify the property ownership lifecycle. Most of what I'll talk about, we're talking about residential because that's kind of the low-hanging fruit of our business. But obviously, there's natural parallels into commercial and property management and tenant properties. So one of the things that I think we can all agree to is that when it comes to, if you think of Angie's List or some of these other service-providing companies, the whole process is kind of complicated. It's difficult. If you own a home or if you've ever owned a home, you probably have drawers full of all the manuals and things like that that are a part of your house, right? And they either end up in the trash or you lose them or something like that. So we decided to put together a platform that is really designed to help keep everything nice and organized, keep everything in a secure space, be transferable to if you were to sell your property, you can transfer this this portal to the person who buys the property. But then on the other side of it, there's a marketplace, and the marketplace is designed so that you can hire service providers, engage with them, sign contracts, make payments, all those sort of things in one cool little environment. This is really an extension of some other products we have, and they're more industrial looking and they didn't really have a consumer look and feel to it. So we came up with this as kind of a consumer portal that takes the relationships. A lot of people, when they buy a new property, first thing they do is they're going to ask their real estate agent, you know, who do I call for this? Who do I call for that? So what we, some of the opportunities we have is to populate this product very quickly with vetted vendors through different real estate groups and things like that so that we can start driving value in the product almost day one. Our business is set up, this product's set up to be a SaaS model. We've identified about 13 different lines of revenue that can show up in this product. Everything from service fees to finance charges. We've incorporated a working capital component to it so vendors can go and borrow money so they don't have to go to the consumer to ask them for upfront payments. So if you're going to remodel their basement or something like that, you know, it always makes people nervous when a contractor says, well, hey, can you give me $5,000 so I can go buy materials? Because we all know that in some cases they take off and you never see your $5,000 again. So we want to help them be able to get that money inside the platform. Obviously, everybody knows the real estate industry is huge, right? Trillions of dollars just in the maintenance and improvement part of properties, just from a residential perspective. And especially given the fact of interest rates going up, people are staying in their homes. If you follow any of the information out there, you'll see that people are going to stay in their homes longer, hopefully spend more money on repairing their homes. So there's a lot of opportunity right now, including people who've made bad buying decisions over the last few years, and now they're faced with having to repair those properties. Just a quick differentiator. One of the things that really makes us different from brands that people have probably heard from is that they get a workflow tool in our product also. Opportunity is now. We're looking for, like I said, we're looking for folks to help us think through how to deploy this product. Obviously, a lot of adjacent space industries that we can go to very, very quickly. A little bit about my background very quickly. I've been doing startups since 2000. I've kind of become addicted to it, and this is just the latest one. We've got a pretty cool team of folks, and we look forward to meeting you and talking with you about what we're trying to do. That's it. Thanks.
Thank you, Jack. And thank you, Jack. All right, our next founder has created an ecosystem that provides financial products and opportunities for those who want to have access as well as opportunities to non-traditional financial products. Coming up next, we have Capway.
Good morning. My name is Sheena Allen, and I'm the founder and CEO of Capway. And we are here creating an ecosystem of financial access and opportunities for everyone. So what we know is the problem is not everyone is given the same access, opportunities, or resources of achieving financial health, especially through the traditional financial system. I know this not just from professional side and data, but also personally, as someone who was born and raised in Mississippi, which is number one for unbanked and underbanked residents per capita. It is one of the poorest states in America, and it's one of those states where most of our grandparents or great-grandparents kept or still keep their money in their house, not in the bank, and where people my age or younger are moving money on their phone, not by walking inside of a bank branch. So because of this problem, we saw a huge opportunity. And that opportunity was, since people are moving away from the traditional financial system for various reasons, how do we create a more modern, trusted financial ecosystem that builds a lifetime value for those that we serve? Now, our first step into doing this, or shall I say the gateway into doing this, was we started off by offering a debit card. And with that debit card, we created a consumer side that currently what we're offering is digital banking. Our debit cards launched to the public in January of this year, and we've already done tens of millions of dollars in transactions. We have a savings tool. Our money goal is our version of our savings account. What that means is if you have a Capway debit card, you swipe it, it rounds up to the nearest dollar, and or you choose how much money is transferred over. We've had thousands of money goals has been created, ranging from emergency savings to vacations to how do I pay my light bill next month. And because this was so popular, we're actually now launching the ability to make your money goals public, which allows anyone from anywhere in the world to come and actually contribute alongside you to your money goal. And last but not least, what's currently available is we do a lot around financial content, financial education, which we see over a million impressions per month. And everything within our ecosystem has to answer one question, which is, does it create financial access and opportunities? But we have made a change. So once again, our gateway was coming in and doing debit cards. But we've made a transition to say, how do we focus on transactions, not just banking? And we did that for a few different reasons. One, even if we start to ask ourselves this question, if we bank you, then what? And then there's also was the pandemic where everybody wants to become a digital bank. And so we didn't want to get bottlenecked down into an oversaturated market. And so we moved away from wanting to bank you to build something to allow you to transact with us. The second thing was actually building a data machine. So we've been allowing data to tell us what is the next product and service that's going to be part of Capway. Credit, investing, microlending. And the second part of that is being able to get data that we actually know other people have been dying to get. Example of that, 10% of the people on Capway who has an active Capway debit card came in completely unbanked. And we know the value of that data. And last but not least, once again, is actually building a lifetime value. So building this ecosystem allows us to build or increase our LTV. But what is our biggest differentiator at Capway? Capway, what machine that actually fuels our consumer products, is not running off of 10, 20, 30, 40 different APIs. The technology that actually fuels Capway is actually built by Capway. We knew that, one, this was going to actually lower our customer acquisition costs over time, but two, it was going to increase our revenue over time, because what we're doing with this next round of funding is actually starting to now explore the enterprise side of who we are at Capway by offering our tech to others. I'll talk about two of those products from our enterprise side, two of our most popular ones. Fraud mapping, something that we created in-house. We've now identified with 20 different fraud rings at Capway. How that works, you can put in a name, a card number, account number, and it actually will identify any form of relationship that someone has had on Capway. And so what that means, I can hit a button, I can actually disable or discontinue any account that's part of a fraud ring. The second one, our most popular demand, is actually our pre-KYC filtering tool. Example of that is I come to Capway. I'm signed up as Sheena at Yandex.com. For those who don't know, Yandex is Russia's version of Google. And that allows us to immediately filter that out so that we save money and not send them to KYC. Customer acquisition from our consumer side is mainly through B2B2C. Enterprise is using our network. It's our team. Thank you.
Thank you, Sheena. All right, up next, we have a founder that is focused on creating content and curriculum to crush your money goals while bridging the divide for racial and gender equality when it comes to finances. So we're going to bring up to the stage Crush Your Money Goals.
Good morning, everybody. I am here to present to you Crush Your Money Goals. We are a financial education platform and community that helps guide women from burnout to financial independence. And truth be told, traditional financial advising and planning has not spoken to women. You know how I know this? Because the women that have come to our platform came after they had terrible experiences in financial planning and advising. And what they really wanted was someone to educate them so that they could take control of their own financial plan. And so that is what we do. We teach women not only how to know and grow their net worth, we also teach them how to flow it, how you make it easy, how you make it simple. It doesn't have to be complicated. And why women are so burned out nowadays is because we are working just as hard as many of the men in our lives, but we are still coming into retirement with a third less in savings. We're still owning only 55 cents to the dollar of what men own, and women are leaving the corporate environments in droves because of burnout. I'm sure many of the women can relate to it in this room. And so specifically, when we looked at the market, we decided to focus on the Henrys, the high-earning, not rich yet, but soon will be women, who not only want financial planning, but they want
empathetic guidance towards the things that they are challenged with every day, not just investing. And they don't just want financial literacy, they want to be financially independent. There is a difference. And so we walk women through our curriculum, and our belief is that we want to teach women how to fish. We don't want them to have to rely on a financial planner the rest of their lives. They can manage their own plans. And so here is a sample of what our curriculum looks like. The company is called Crush Your Money Goals because it's based off of 5 simple steps that spell out the word crush, and we have over 100 modules in our current product that teach women everything from how to manage a budget, to be able to negotiate their salaries, to be able to start their own business. One of my favorite students is here today. And to date, we have made over $425,000 in revenue with our existing product. We have built over 25,000 people in our community over social media, and we've had 400 students enrolled with an average revenue per month of $20,000. And students are coming in paying anywhere from $99 all the way up to $1,500, depending on how customized they want their education to be. But most of all, I just love these women. These women are executives at many of the companies that you have heard, but they were afraid to go to a financial planner because they make a lot of money and they thought they should have known better. And they wanted someone who actually lived the life that they lived, me being a corporate professional myself once upon a time, and they wanted to work with someone who preached what they taught. I mean, the other way around. So here are some examples of clients that we have partnered with in 2022 that we have been brought in to teach financial education to their underrepresented employees. You might notice that some of these companies are financial institutions themselves. So it begs to wonder, why aren't they able to teach this to their employees themselves? And we were brought in because we were told that we were more relatable and that we were able to really talk to what women were asking for when it came to financial advice. As we all know, there is going to be no shortage of need for financial planning and advice, but what we're really focused is on teaching people how to teach themselves. And especially in the next 5 years, with the trends in mental health, with the trends in the difficulty to retire, with the trends in economics, with recession and inflation and job instability, more and more women are looking for education on how they can save themselves rather than waiting for someone to save them. Now, while there are a lot of competitors in this space, we are not as competitive with them in the sense that we are highly niched into the target within women that we are focused on. And truth be told, a lot of these companies have just taken the same traditional advice, put a pink logo on it, and then called it for women. We have always been women first, and we are focused on making it easy to understand, and we are focused on empathy and the whole life cycle of making a financial choice, not just investments. I'm Bernadette Joy. I have recently been named one of the 25 most influential new voices of money by Next Advisor, which is the financial arm of Time Magazine. But personally, I have lived and practiced what I preach. I paid off $300,000 of debt in 3 years and built my first $1 million of net worth self-taught. And that is what I teach my students on how to do for themselves. Here is my team. They are awesome. They're experts in all sorts of areas that I am not an expert in. And I am looking for partners who are really interested in helping us teach women how to be financially independent and grow with us over the next 3 years. Thank you.
Thank you, Bernadette. We've been hearing from so many founders. Again, if you want to connect with them, there's many networking opportunities for you to do so. And of course, go to CrowdWorks to learn more about their businesses. The next organization aims to make email and Excel a thing of the past. So that's actually that's a big thing there, right? We all use way too much of that. And so coming up to the stage to talk a little bit more about their one-click reinsurance offering, let's bring up to the stage Digitech.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Alex. I'm the co-founder and CEO of Digitech. So we are currently connecting 2 Android reinsurance / insurance companies into one single marketplace across 15 African countries, and that represents over 50 million policies processed worth $2 billion USD gross written premiums. As Africa is poised to reach and grow beyond 150 billion by 2027, our solution, Digitech, is also poised to grow between 10 and 20x. I'm going to explain why in a couple of slides. So look, the moment 15 billion reinsured policies are at risk of operational losses. Why? Because of manual handling for Excel and email. So this situation leads to a couple of troubles, such as issues to track in real time the transactions, issues to know when they exceed the capacity to pay claims, or just to know which deals to write more of or deals to just stay away from. Yet, if Africa is the second fastest growing insurance market in the world with a 7% CAGR over the next 5 years, it is one of the most inefficient ones, where companies spend between 12 to 20% of their revenues in admin expenses. And that's one of the key reasons why Hyperion exists, because it can cut through this inefficiency almost from day one. Look, if we look by top-bottom approach or bottom approach, which a minimum of 1 to 1.5B, which translates into a final 50 million sum per year. It's worth mentioning that this is 50% less than what a large consortium of African reinsurers has estimated to be. So our solution, our answer to this is called Hyperion. It's an AI-powered re/insurance platform currently processing 92,000 reinsurance policies on a daily basis, all the way from premium subscription to claims management in billing, including the regulatory compliance. All of this wouldn't matter without our strong revenue model, which is built on the free tire engine. So stage one onboarding and maintenance fee have helped us get off the ground, but what is really going to ensure a fast and sustainable growth is the premium placement fee with potential to reach 250K on a monthly basis. The ice on the cake is going to be our basically instant payments clearance room with the potential to reach 1.5 million on a monthly basis by year 2025, year 2026. And if we look at the current traction, maybe we're doing one or two things right. 77 million transactions processed for 200 companies across 15 countries worth over 2 billion. Look, this initial burst that you see has been achieved with zero to none funding. And we believe that if this burst is mechanically nurtured and fueled, 10 to 20x acceleration is possible within the next 5 years. And this is going to be done with double-digit growth while maintaining our historical 80% growth margin. This initial burst in traction shouldn't make us forget that competition is also part of the equation. If in Africa we benefit really from an early stage mover advantage, the story is a bit different on a global scale. Yet our strong knowledge of the markets combined with basically the two-sided network effect benefit from is going to help us increase the gap with the others. One of the ways that we want to make difference with the others is the go-to-market strategy, threefold. Like signing with Africare, the largest reinsurance-based African company, is going to basically help foster the usage of Hyperion. And secondly, we know that a sizable chunk, 30% of the deals are written through the Lloyd's of London. So we want companies to just do that through Hyperion, but through a digital door in just a few clicks. And then thirdly, we'll achieve technology superiority and dominance through our partnership with Critical Future and leveraging our natural data lake of 50 million policies poised to grow by over a billion within the next 5 years. The team behind that bring a combined 60 years of experience in various fields, reinsurance, insurance, technology, telecom, and finance. I myself claim multiple degrees, including an MBA summa cum laude from Holt, various certificates from Stanford and MIT in blockchain and machine learning. And I'm surrounded by a couple of PhDs, including our CTO and our chief actuary officer. We're supported by a strong board with captains of industries in their respective field. If you guys want to know how we're going to grow from 2 billion USD gross written premiums to over 50 billion within the next 5 years, I welcome you and talk to us. That's why we're raising 1.5 million with already 500,000 of the bank account secured. My name is Alex, and I'm a co-founder and CEO of Digitech.
Thank you, Alex. Okay, up next, we have an organization that provides a spare change roundup service to consumers, as well as a roundup as a service infrastructure to online platforms. Let's bring up to the stage Roundly X.
Hey, Hey, everyone, and thanks for having me. I'm Andrew Elliott, the co-founder at RoundlyX, which has built non-custodial spare change Roundup infrastructure that can round up into anything on the internet with a buy button. We started in the digital asset space, rounding up our users' spare change from everyday purchases into their favorite digital assets at their favorite platforms. We've recently added charitable giving, rounding up in the same way into over 1,500 charitable organizations, things that our users care about, and we'll keep adding Roundup verticals. You bought a cup of coffee this morning. It was $1.50. That's 50 cents to the nearest whole dollar. That amount goes into whatever you care about, and we keep adding the Roundup verticals. That's how we look to consumers. That's the B2B side. It's an app. It's in both the app stores. You can download it today. On the B2B side, we're a SaaS provider, providing Roundups as a service. A Roundup feature for your fintech platform, your platform that's online, you want to grow transaction volume, you want a Roundup feature, but you don't want to build it yourself, you don't want to service it, you can leverage ours. So far, users love it. Is that green one? Okay. Yeah, users love it so far. Over 35,000 user accounts. We do about $20,000 a day in spare change Roundups. This is just a number of users sharing their experience online. The partners are the same way. Again, we're driving their KPIs. We're driving donations into the charities. We're driving transaction volume at fintech partners. That's what they like to see, and they're incentivized to tell their user base about it because we make their users more active and in the process make their users our own. This is what it looks like. I'm rounding up into several things all at once, all managed in one united dashboard. I can see my entire net worth across multiple platforms, Coinbase, E-Trade, name them, thousands, all in one screen, not logging into each of them separately. I can then toggle what I want to be involved in with my spare change today. I want a dollar cost average into Bitcoin. It's a good time to buy Bitcoin when it's low, not high. I can dollar cost into what I want to support, the causes. I'm personally rounding up into the American Cancer Society. I can also round up into other things like spending credits at top brands like Airbnb. We're building the hub for Roundups. All of these things in one dashboard, leveraging the partner's infrastructure. It's super scalable, super low CapEx, and it's everything our users care about. The TAM is huge. You know, everything on the internet with a buy button. With the two Roundup verticals we have live right now, cryptocurrency and charitable giving, it's roughly $1.5 trillion SAM. But when you look at it, it's really a $360 million recurring revenue opportunity per year. Traction's great. Over $200 million has been connected to the platform. That's users connecting their accounts and us being able to see those balances across multiple platforms. So in a world where money is super mobile, if I can see it, I can influence it. It's a different idea of what AUM is. AUM in the old world was it's got to be in a bank vault somewhere. In the new world, it's super mobile, and if I can see it, I can help you move it around or give you ideas of what to do. Over 35,000 user accounts, we do private API integrations with top platforms. These are not public endpoints. We have to have a relationship in order to round up into these strategic partners. We tend to do initial discussions with the C-suite, and then it moves off for technical development. We make money several ways, mostly recurring, whether it's our B2B side, which is the SaaS Roundups as a service that the partner platforms are paying us to enable that tool set, or it's the users using the Roundup service on B2C. There are other Roundup apps. They tend to be siloed and custodial, meaning that they only want you in their ecosystem. Acorns. It's only the Acorns balance. They're not in a hurry to show you your E-Trade balance in there. They don't aggregate anything. We aggregate everything to show you your entire wealth across multiple platforms in one spot and give you one UI in which to interact with each of those connected platforms. That's different, that's new, and it's powerful for users. No more logging into accounts separately. It saves you time. The key to the model, how we win, is doing exactly that, being an aggregated Roundup platform that is non-custodial. So we're not taking your money and then tripping all the wires on custody. As we all know, custody can involve some problems. We're leveraging what's already there, what's already in place. That's how we win, and we're highly scalable all over the world. doing it that way. We can be in any market for less than $10,000. The team's highly complimentary. My co-founders here, please meet us. Andrew@roundlyx.com if you have questions. Thanks.
Thank you, Andrew, and thank you to all of the founders. Thank you so much. Arbo, Freeman, Capway, Popper. Also, we had Crush Your Money Goals, Roundly X, as well as Digitech. Thank you all for coming out and sharing your business. If you are in the position to help these folks grow and scale their business, head to CrowdWorks, check out their one pager, figure out how you can support them. If you want to connect with them on a one-on-one while they're here, please do so. Look them up on LinkedIn, their website, all of that. Make sure you're connecting to these folks that are out here trying to make a difference and do big things and grow their business. Well, that is it for this particular session. We will take a quick break and return at 11. We will have a TURF-specific investment thesis coming up at 11, but until then, enjoy your quick break. And let's give one big round of applause for all those founders that got up today and did such an amazing job. Thank you so much, and hope you guys enjoy the rest of Venture 135. I'm Ty Chandler with AvidXchange. See you guys soon.